Читинская государственная телевизионная и радиовещательная компания, Сахандинский государственный биосферный заповедник, Банк Забайкальский представляют фильм Надежды Павленко «Тропою Паласа».
Along the path of Palas.
Автор сценария Валерий Немеров. Операторы Сергей Романов, Олег Сукач, Сергей Белоусов. Музыкальное оформление Владимира Шайдурова.
Забайкалье, a remarkable territory with all the variety of natural colors found on the earth. The territory, stretching from Lake Baikal to the Amur River, changes its scenery all along the way. Alpine peaks, with their gay, iridescent profusion of flowers, are replaced by vast steppes, extending to the horizon, and smelling of lavishly scented grass. Then you see the taiga, placid and silent, as if stilled by some mysterious force. All this territory is cobwebbed with silver threads of rivers, hurriedly running with a raucous babble, either into Baikal or the Pacific. Beautiful and diverse though nature in the rest of Забайкалье may be, it nevertheless cannot rival the bare-topped Mount Сахандо, a unique area that has managed to retain for centuries its life-affirming force, power, and primordial grandeur. The famous traveler and scientist Peter Simon Palas called the mountain the most majestic of all the Даурский range, and it was he who made the first path to the top of Сахандо.
Чтобы попасть в заповедник,
standing at the foot of the mountain, you can hear the primeval and everlasting voice of nature that speaks so eloquently here. And if you sense its purity, you come to realize the unique and inimitable character of the picture you see, as well as its might and fragility. And then you can understand why it was here, in the Сахандо area, that the State Biospheric Reserve was established in 1973, laying the foundation for the study and preservation of all of Чита region's flora and fauna. Spring Melodies. Peter Simon Palas is known to have ascended Mount Сахандо in the summer of 1770. We decided to begin our acquaintance with the Сахандинский State Biospheric Reserve early in spring, when nature is just waking up from its winter slumber. We arrived in the village of Кейра, from which Палас started his landmark expedition exactly 225 years after his trip began. On the day of our arrival, and for some days to follow, Сахандо and the тайга were overlaid with снow. It's no wonder. In Забайкалье, spring doesn't arrive in a day. Here, March, April, and May are the months when winter takes great pains to prolong its influence. The persevering winter spreads its white, down-like blanket over the land with the same ease that a sudden spring warmth washes it away into the valleys whose rivers are already impatient to rid themselves of their ice coverlet. Even in May, the temperature in the reserve may range from 20 to 60 degrees Fahrenheit. Such fluctuations in temperature cannot help but affect the renewing life. The first heralds of spring are snowdrops, the first flowers of the Сахандо bouquet. But spring gets the upper hand over winter only with the blossoming of багульник, the local member of the rhododendron family. When the mountains become tinged with the lilac and pink of багульник, the clock hands are set to show real summertime. Videotaping the spring nature was quite an effort. To get on tape the dripping of the thawing snow, cameraman Олег Сукач, a tall man, had to lie down on the still half-frozen ground. Cameraman Сергей Белоусов, trying to approach purple willows coming into leaf, had to slog through knee-deep slush. But all this means nothing when compared to the pictures of the springtime reserve that we were able to capture. Unfortunately, the videotape was unable to record the fragrance of the woods awakened to life by the gracious sun. This fragrance is a perceptible reflection of this life-giving force without which the тайга could not exist. And the exquisite summer watercolors, only increase the impression of the revivifying energy of the taiga. Summer watercolors. Translated from the region's aboriginal language, Tungus, Sakhando means the main mountain. This is the translation given by Peter Simon Palas in his classic travel book, Journey Through Various Provinces of the Russian Empire, published in 1772. As Sakhando is the main peak of South Забайкалье, so summer here is the epitome of nature's triumph. It's not surprising that Pelas was not sparing in his description of Sakhando in its summer finery. We set ourselves a similar task, to devote the main part of our film to the description of wonderful summer time, short though it may be, in Забайкалье. Anxious to make our story a certain confirmation of what the outstanding scientist had written of the reserve area, we decided to travel the same way, on the same path taken by the world-famous traveler. We set off from the Агуца River, together with the reserve's director, Виктор Яшнов, and huntsman Vladimir Goncharov, our guides in this journey of many days. We were to cover about 300 kilometers of Palas route, often moving along tracks left by animals. These animal tracks are easy to see, but they are made, as a rule, in nearly impassable places. But the harder the path, the more surprise it has in store. It will take you invariably to some place of interest, to some natural formation, capturing some essence of this rarely seen part of the world. The path we took us to an Аршан, a mineral spring noted for its curative value and the significance of its location. For centuries, five springs welling up from the earth in this area have been medicinal for the local animal life. If you are lucky, you may see the natives of the Сакхандо Reserve nearby such an infirmary. Elk, roe deer, lynx, and wolf. We were able to tape only roe deer, vashenka, as they are called locally. Thank you.
учитывая осторожность и пугливость этих грозных
These animals are known to be alert and cautious. Our cameramen, Сергей Романов and Сергей Белоусов, and our director, Надежда Павленко, had to spend several days in a specially built log blind to be able to observe these graceful animals without scaring them away. But very rare video shots of the taiga realm, with all the diversity of its life, were the reward for this temporary inconvenience.
Аршан на нашем пути к Саханду был последним перекрестком звезд.
The Аршан was the last landmark on our way to Сахандо. With every day, the forest was getting thinner until at last, on a rainy morning, we saw boundless rocky fields leading to the summit, here known as Курум.
Здесь нам пришлось оставить лошадей до возвращения.
We had to leave our horses until the way back, left to rely only on our endurance.
Этот многочасовой переход часто
It was a hard and long ascent, dangerous at times on account of unsteady stones rolling down the slope. But having reached the base of its bare dome, we were fascinated by the most ravishing watercolors of Сахандо, the alpine meadows. Thank you. The alpine meadows were our last stop before mounting the peak of Sakhandō. While climbing, we could see only boulders covered with ancient lichens, but otherwise bereft of any vegetation. For several hours, we climbed those seemingly sullen, but at the same time marvelous slopes, before we reached the spot marked on the map as the peak of Sakhandō, commonly referred to as Galets. The height is 2,504 meters, or 8,215 feet above sea level. From this age-old gray peak, we were treated to a breathtaking panorama. Standing here, on the border between earth and sky, we realized why the Tungus had called Sakhandō not only the main mountain, but also the bowl of gods. The prospect was splendid, and in its vastness, serene and impressive. The way back always seems shorter, whatever predicaments may be awaiting you. The farther we moved away from the peak, the more often we turned around to take a look, as we were unwilling to say farewell to its bewitching primeval splendor. And then we promised to return to the reserve in autumn, in the season of crimson leaf fall and first frost, to come again for October's variety. October variegation. Autumn. In the reserve, it sets in gradually, without haste and bustle. But this deliberation only adds to its enchantment. Autumn seems generous enough to let everything bask in the sun, so that all beings, animate and inanimate, might survive the severe and long-lasting winter ahead. In October, the taiga is often swept by chilling winds. The first frosts bind the streams with ice, and frequent snowfalls clothe the land with a white blanket. Then comes the time of white paths. The time of white paths. Winter in the reserve is a season to accumulate force for the subsequent revival. Everything is stiff and still, filled with the lone concern of preserving sprouts of future life. Lifeless, though, seem the white valleys. Ice-clad are the rivers and lakes. The taiga is wrapped in slumber. The mountains stand like sentinels at their posts. Life hasn't stopped for a minute. It has only sunk into silence and tranquility. Let's stroll about the taiga in its winter attire, but in silence, so that we won't disturb its peace and wonder. Blessed be the coming generations, that this beauty may remain for all to see.
Над фильмом работали диктор Оксана Самойленко, компьютерная графика Галина Васеева, Петр Васеев, инженеры видеозаписи Алексей Небальсин, Петр Приказчиков, автообеспечение Николай Кушнир, Николай Пальшин. Читинская государственная телерадиокомпания.